In the last video we have learned how to backup Zammad. So now let's talk about restoring or even migrating Zammad to a new system. This video is not for you if you are using a Docker-based installation. Foremost, I'll talk about the restoration workflow. It is a direct part of the migration, so make sure to watch it. If you haven't created a backup yet, watch my backup video first. Zammad comes with an onboard restoration script. It supports restoration from the same database type only. Restoring Zammad requires a fresh installation. If that's not the case, all your existing information will be lost upon restoration. You're not bound to the same distribution during a restoration, if you preferably only backed up database and attachments. The restore process would also work on failed updates, with the complete removal of Zammad and installation of the old version. This is not covered by this video for complexity reasons. Okay, enough talking, let's get into it. Let's assume you changed the configuration of Zammad and at some point made a mistake. Lucky for you, you have created a backup before changing everything. Enabled maintenance mode and disabled all communication channels to minimize data loss. This scenario is the easiest one because you are restoring to the same system. Make sure to stop Zammad. Now you can run opt Zammad config backup Zammad underscore restore sh. Answer the first question of the script with yes if you want to restore a backup. Now you will be prompted to provide a timestamp of your database and file dump. Usually the sorting order is from old to new. You can double check this by listing your backup directory. On Debian and Ubuntu-based systems, the restore will begin and overwrite the previous state. If you're running a SUSE or Red Hat-based installation, the restore will most likely cancel because of an empty password. This is technically normal but needs to be corrected for the backup and restore script. I will explain the step more detailed in the migration chapter. The restore process may take a while. It will automatically start somewhat after. If you encounter issues after restoring, take a look into your production log file. Most issues lay there. A search index rebuild might be a good idea depending on how much you changed. The migration process is fairly straightforward as well. Unless you have a very strict documentation policy, check for possible performance tuning or environment settings for Zammad. For a current environment setting list, please consult the environment documentation page of Zammad. In our case, the only thing that has been adjusted was the web concurrency. By running Zammad config get web concurrency, you'll receive the current value of this setting. You'll need this information for your destination system later. Make sure you have a fresh Zammad installation according to documentation. I went ahead and already installed two samples to reduce complexity of this video. On your source system, now enable maintenance mode. This will restrict sessions to admins only. It's also a good idea to disable communication channels. Disable and stop Zammad. Disabling the service ensures the service won't start accidentally. Now's the perfect moment to create the backup. Remember, we are running a backup to a NFS storage with attachments and database only. On your destination system, now configure the backup configuration file to fit the situation. It won't hurt to use the source system's content as long as your paths are still correct. Set performance tuning if applicable. Stop Zammad on the destination system. These steps can safely be done during the backup process on your source to skip waiting time. If you are not using an NFS shell like I do, now copy the backup files to the new system. Usually SCP is the best option for this. Execute opt Zammad config backup Zammad restore sh. If you're running a SUSE or Red Hat based installation, the restore will most likely cancel because of an empty password. To fix that, run opt Zammad contrib backup Zammad db user helper sh. This script will automatically reset your database user's password and write it to Zammad's configuration. This script works for local PostgreSQL installations only. Usually remote database server or MariaDB setups will already have this configured correctly. If not, fix this issue manually. Also check your PGA/HBA conf of your PostgreSQL server. Especially CentOS prefers ident identification, but scripts methods require MD5 instead. Make sure to restart PostgreSQL after and stop Zammad again. The restart process will automatically fix file permissions, attempt to clear the cache of Zammad and start Zammad. Clearing the cache fails if you're restoring the whole Zammad directory. This is the case if you haven't changed the backup script configuration as suggested. This is out of scope of this video. If the source and destination Zammad version differ, stop Zammad. Make sure to execute the database migrations. After that, start Zammad. In case you skip versions, you may want to run opt-zammad-contrib-packager-io-post-install-sh instead. This will also migrate the database along other upgrade tasks. Rebuild your Elasticsearch search index. Depending on the number of tickets and users, you may want to do this in a second terminal or screen session. Now that's basically it. In your environment, make sure to adjust your Zammad DNS entry to the new system and adjust the web server configuration if not done already. Keep in mind that DNS may take some time to update. Now that's it. Pretty easy, right? Please consider subscribing to the channel for more videos. It helps a lot. Until next time, take care.